Warning, this video contains rapidly flashing contrasting colors via eruption footage which may have the potential to trigger seizures for individuals with photosensitive epilepsy or similar conditions. Video begins in 3, 2, 1. At 2:55 a.m. local time earlier today, the Kanlaon Volcano in the Philippines explosively erupted, sending many thousands of tons of molten rock high into the sky. Since part of the eruption column was too dense to rise on a buoyant column of hot air, it collapsed back to the ground, generating a series of pyroclastic flows which traveled at least 2.5 kilometers downslope. While this view of the eruption is in infrared, thus showing heat signatures, widespread reports from locals show that a widespread orange glow soon became visible. The orange glow primarily originated from the pyroclastic flows, which contained lava fragments, which I estimate traveled at a speed of approximately 66.23 miles per hour or 106.59 kilometers per hour. The moving incandescent fragments might initially look like falling blocks tumbling down a mountain from a small-scale lava flow, but are in fact being propelled on top of a cushion of hot air, making them roll significantly. Once the pyroclastic flow ended, some of the lava blocks within them ignited vegetation fires where they fell, creating an even more intense orange glow visible from afar. As the eruption column continued upwards, many millions of tiny particles of ash rubbed together to create static electricity, creating volcanic lightning. This plume may have ended up reaching the highest an eruption column has ever achieved from the Kanlaon volcano, but there are conflicting reports. One source suggests the eruption plume reached 22,710 feet or 6,922 meters, while another suggests it reached 46,000 feet or 14,021 meters. This confusion between sources likely is owed to the fact that a rainstorm was ongoing at the time, meaning either the cloud height of the storm could have been confused for the eruption plume by automatic sensors, or that an updraft propelled some ash further upwards than the rest of the plume. Based on the limited amount of ash which fell on these select areas, I tend to lean towards the lesser figure. While the ash emissions from today's eruption were limited, this is probably because they largely fell around its summit, weighted down by heavy rain at the time. With this in mind, I'd probably rank today's eruption as either the second or third largest eruption from Kanlaon of the four major explosions it has produced since 2024 began. The good news is that today's eruption of Kanlaon, which has been the most active volcano in the Philippines since the 20th century began, was actually somewhat expected. There were abundant signs that a large plug had recently formed in Kanlaon's magma conduit, causing pressure to build underneath it. As this pressure started to become significant enough to break overlying rock, it generated a swarm of 243 volcanic earthquakes. As a result, Five Oaks put out a special notice on May 12th, and a day later, the eruption finally happened. Today's eruption once again thankfully caused no deaths or injuries, as no one had entered Kanlaon's 6-kilometer exclusion zone, and extremely deadly hazards remained within this exclusion zone. But does it pose any dangers to those outside of this zone? Yes, potentially, but only if you live near a stream or river or right above the areas it semi-frequently floods. Why? Due to the potential for small to medium-sized lahars. I'm not yet sure how much loose ash and pyroclastic flow material was just emplaced on Kanlaon's edifice. The concern to me is to be aware that the loose material could be swept away into riverbeds to form a lahar, overtopping their banks and having the theoretical potential to damage or destroy structures and harm people. However, with a lack of information, I cannot yet make an unofficial judgment in this regard. While more similarly sized or even more powerful eruptions could technically occur from Kanlaon in the near future, none of this volcano's prior major explosions during its current eruptive episode were closely followed by another major explosion. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube for supporting my work.